hopefully it's going to be a very exciting series for us. After the World Cup, we've sort of come back and said we need to change the way that we play. And sort of the proof in that is the selections that we have made. We've selected guys who play a different brand of cricket. And we don't want that to change once they put the England shirt on. So I'm excited to see them play. I'm excited to see them take the opportunity that present itself over this course of the series. Being aggressive, 99% of it is having the players to sort of set the standard and set the example of being aggressive. We struggled throughout the World Cup to do that simply because we didn't perform well enough. And as I said, the guys we have brought in do something different, and we want that to continue. And if they play as well as they have done in county cricket, things will be very exciting. I think it makes you appreciate every time you play for England. It makes every win more sort of enjoyable, simply because we've gone through a dry spell now of not having a run of wins for some time. So it does make you appreciate things a lot more. Yeah, certainly. And it's great to have that backing. Andrew's also on the same page as me, Farby and Trevor, as the direction is in which we want to take this team and the brand of cricket we want to play. We want to be sort of unclouded in the way that we play and put opposition sides under pressure as much as we can. For a long time now, we've been behind the eight ball in one-day cricket, and we've fallen behind a long way. And it's time for a catch-up. It still might take a little bit of time, but certainly I can get my views across. Things can be a lot more clearer, and I've certainly been involved in selection, so I've got the squad that I've wanted. It's hugely important, and it's very important to recognise that, as you said, it won't come off all the time, but the intention of playing in the right manner is key, and it has to be key for a long period of time. Otherwise, if you ditch it after a few games, it won't work. I know Trevor's one-day sort of strategy revolves a lot around having athletes in your side and having gun fielders, and then a couple of specifics with guys being able to turn the ball both ways and having your quicks looking constantly to take wickets, and obviously being aggressive with the bat. He tends to keep things quite simple. One of his biggest strengths as a coach is his ability to take any pressure away from a player and make it feel as if it's any normal game. My experience with him has been brilliant. Yeah. As I've said before, he's a player's coach. He's very relatable. He's sort of behind the scenes, does things you want a coach to do. And then come the limelight, he's nowhere to be seen, which is something I have a lot of admiration for. I think we're both different within our own right, and I think the teams are the same. We're at two different stages, particularly us, having sort of been knocked out of the World Cup early and watched New Zealand get to the final, playing this brand of cricket that has driven world one-day cricket forward over the last few years. So that is the brand of cricket that we want to play. We don't have to look very far or any further than the World Cup. We played both finalists once, and that is the brand of cricket that we want to play. I think speaking with Andrew, his view certainly is that there's going to be a difference between tests and one days. There's going to be a bigger priority on one day cricket or white ball cricket, including T20. And I think that's the change that's made me think, you know what, hold on, we're actually going to make some progress here. I think there are plans being put in progress to prioritise tournaments in the future and actually earmark it instead of overloading with test match priority. Obviously, my relationship with Peter it's grown significantly since the start of the World Cup and all the way till the end. He was very good to me. I learnt a lot more about him once I was captain, as opposed to being a player, but certainly it's unfortunate that the position he's found himself in. My batting at the moment is actually in a lot better place than it was at the World Cup. For some reason, I've always gone to the IPL and come back a better player I can't put my finger on why. And that's been the case this year. I feel a lot more at ease with where I'm at. And handling the captaincy is before the World Cup has been a nice distraction, so I hope that continues. I mean, we're trying to connect as much as we can with past players, and to have somebody like Dermot around is really good, very knowledgeable character. I think it's important that particularly the younger guys who are coming into the squad recognise that there's a lot more to playing cricket for England than actually pulling on the jersey, and that sort of emphasises it. In the ideal world, we'd have our own world-renowned domestic tournament that everybody wants to play in. And you'll see our younger guys flourish in that. There'll be a very high standard of cricket being played and guys being put under pressure majority of the time they go out to bat or bowl or field. So in an ideal world, that's what we want. But there's been a lot of change in personnel, and I think the way in which we play dictates how we play, and that has a reflection in anything that allows me to be a captain, or it allows me a bit more freedom as a captain.